Now Kent Bazemore will join us. And KB, you guys have a 24-point comeback against the Clippers, a 22-point comeback against the Lakers, a 19-point comeback against the Heat. How did you guys come back and win this game?
It's not the foundation. Fess Ezeli said a long time ago, we're Warriors, and you know, that's what this organization represents. You know, a bunch of guys, you know, staying the course, and we came over here every time out. We stayed in it. You know, Coach Kerr did a great job of keeping our spirits up, and the chips are down right now. We got a bunch of guys with our back against the wall, and we're just coming out swinging.
One thing I love about your game is you're always ready for your opportunity. You get in the game, you're unafraid, and obviously Steph's the guy you guys are looking for a lot of the time, but you're not just waiting for that. You're not just sitting back and hoping that he makes something happen. You're ready to attack. What does it take to stay there in your mind and that mentality?
Well, it's just a credit to Steph, you know, instilling confidence in, you know, his teammates. You know, he's the best player in the game right now, and I was telling him all night he's the best player, best shooter on the planet. And, you know, the pass he made to Wiggs there in the corner just shows, you know, he's going to believe in his teammates. And when you got a guy like that that's putting the battery in your back, you know, you feel like, you know, the world's at your feet.
Now, Steph never loses confidence, but you've known him and been his friend for so long. When he was scuffling, even missing wide-open looks, were you the one saying, hang in there, hang in there, hang in there? Because we almost predicted in the overtime he would hit those threes, and he did.
Yeah, I mean, my rookie year, I should tell him, you know, the percentages always catch up, and he's been shooting lights out all season. And, you know, that last, 5 minutes overtime, last 7 minutes of this game, you know, he really turned it up for us and took the ISO there late and to put us up six and kind of seal the deal.
Ken, dealing with adversity, do you guys almost enjoy and embrace the adversity? Draymond's a late scratch. You got no bigs. Bam Adebayo is trying to bully you guys, putting people in the basket. Do you enjoy just embracing that and looking at his opportunity to kind of shock the world in a way?
Well, you just got to understand it's a 48-minute game, and, you know, there are ebbs and flows all night, and you just got to stay the course. I felt like we're playing the most consistent style of basketball all night, you know, moving the ball, getting great looks, and like I said, the percentages will catch up. Guys stayed ready, and we knocked some shots down, got some big-time offensive rebounds, and pulled out a great win before we head out on the road.
Yeah, I tell you what, 7 of the 8 on the road now to finish off this first half. And you know where I don't want the percentages to catch up? This is the best three-point shooting year you've ever had, man.
Yes, sir.
Fun to watch you pull from deep right now.
Yes, sir. I came out here early in September and got some great work in with Steph down in Atherton. And, I shoot with him before the game, and just to watch him shoot and see the ball go through the hoop gives me a lot of confidence when I'm out there shooting. And, you know, he's so loose during his warm-ups, and it's just contagious. And I go out and play with a big heart. You know, I've been in the NBA for – this is my 9th season. I've been around a little bit, and I've been putting in a ton of work, and, I'm grateful for the opportunity to let it show.
Well, Kent, thanks for stopping. Get in there with your teammates. This is a crazy one.
Yeah.
This is a perfect one to go on a long road trip after a win like this.
Yeah, we're going to be riding high, man. It feels great.
Good work, brother.
All right, gentlemen. That is Kent Bazemore, the Warriors 3-1 on the homestand. They never got to 16 wins a year ago. They do that tonight, improbably, and they're going to talk about it. Bonte, Jennifer, and Darrell Wright, Warrior postgame live. The wildest one we've seen at Chase Center becomes a Warrior win.
Are you not entertained by this squad here? Down 15 at the half. It looks bleak in the fourth quarter, which we'll get to in just a second. But the Warriors somehow, some way, come out with the victory and overtime win over the Miami Heat to close this four-game homestand with the victory. They were 3-1 on this homestand and now go on the road for 7 of their last 8 in the first half of the season. And welcome to Post Game Live, presented by Toyota. NBA champ Darrell Wright, the Hall of Famer Jennifer Azy, Final Four MVP with Stanford. And what a win for the Golden State Warriors. Curry goes 8 for 25, but Bazemore steps up. Oubre steps up. Wiggins with big minutes. And then, of course, Pascal coming off the bench. What a win for the Golden State Warriors.
Great win for the Warriors. The will to win, and that's what they went out there and did. They never gave up. You never seen guys head down. They stayed the course, and Steve Kerr tapped that right hand. Called his closer out to go out there and finish it off. But they played a great game.
They played a great game. And I think Steve's coaching and character come through because, you know, Bazemore in his interview is talking about how Steve kept them positive. And that's just his nature. That's Steph's nature. They just go and they keep going. And tonight was amazing. I don't think I've seen a game like this in a long time.
Maybe the best win of the season when you consider right before tip-off, we got news that Draymond Green was scratched with right ankle soreness. And everybody's thinking, how are the Warriors going to do this? And it started off ugly, but they hung in. And then crunch time came around, and the Warriors made some winning plays there, closing the fourth quarter with a 20-6 run. And you see Steph Curry here with the ball getting doubled to Durrell. They just started swinging the ball, and Bazemore, Pascal, going to the cup here and finishing strong.
Finishing strong. The ball movement was there all night. You know, they missed a few shots, you know, a bunch of threes that I know a lot of those guys won back. But how they close this game, getting offensive rebounds, moving the ball, going up strong, and ones, man, they did it all.
Yeah, I mean, they were moving the ball, like you said, in the first half. Shots weren't falling, but they were more aggressive, especially towards the end of the fourth quarter and then into overtime. You know, there was nothing to stop. Bazemore was like a freight train on the offensive board. And that's an area I think the team's been a little bit weak this season, so that was nice to see.
And you see Bazemore there with the drive there, 8 rebounds, Jennifer, 23 points, 23 big points for Kent Bazemore. You see it again, Durrell, he's attacks none here, goes up with his left off the backboard, nice little soft touch there to tie the game in the fourth quarter. And what a moment for the Golden State Warriors for this team without Looney, without Wiseman, as we just mentioned here, Draymond scratched right before the game, their facilitator, their leader here, and they go to overtime. And let's check out the overtime stats because they were pretty. It was nip and tuck. Nobody could make a basket. And then, as you know, Bazemore starts it off here, Durrell, with the bucket.
Yeah, he got it going. But this didn't start in overtime. Baze came out tonight, and he played well from as soon as he got in that game. So this was that carryover from the first half. He saw he had a mismatch every time, you know, with the Robinson and Hero on him, and he took advantage of it. And he made some big-time plays for this team tonight and gave this team a chance to win.
And then Curry woke up, Jennifer.
He did wake up. And, you know, you kind of were waiting all game for it, right? Like, he can't miss this many shots this many times in a row, and you know he's playing to win. So what he's going to forget about those misses, play to win, do what it takes. Great pass for that three by Wiggins, too. So he did anything he needed to win.
No doubt. And then, of course, Curry here to cap it off here. Warriors up three. They need a bucket. He just goes with the step back. Ooh. Oh, come here, Nunn. Dance with me here on the three-point line. Nothing but splash.
And Durrell called it. He said, watch, step back.
Yes, I call game, baby. Yeah.
Call game.
That was a dagger right
there. That was his dagger. And Zaza, his former teammate here, it's not about how you start. It's about how you finish it. Steph Curry finishes it with a bang there. Look, overall, 8 for 25, 5 for 20 from the three-point line. Couldn't buy a bucket, but that, next thing you know, he does score over 20 points and has the 11 assists. So he stuck with it. And you knew, Jennifer, it was just a matter of time, as Durrell called it.
Well, it was a matter of time. And also, it was nice seeing four players have over 20 points. So, you know, maybe Steph had a little bit of a, for him, not a great night. But, you know, the rest of the team really stepped up.
And it's all about how you finish the game. Mm-hmm. You know, shoot or shoot. That's what they say.
Yep. Shoot or shoot, baby.
You know what I mean? And Steph, you know, him having that type of mindset of next play, and having that short-term memory, I wasn't surprised at all when he hit that dagger. But, you know, his teammates, they kept him in the game. They kept him motivated, like we heard Bazemore say at the end, and he finished the game for him.
And, Jennifer, as you mentioned, four players had over 20 points tonight for the Golden State Warriors. First time that's happened since 2016. Back in November of 2016 against the Lakers, Curry, Kevin Durant, Klay Thompson, and an old friend of ours, Ian Clark, with 21 in that game. So the Warriors making a bit of history here. Let's talk about Steph Curry, though. Let's discuss his game tonight because the Heat were all over him, and we know the rapport he has with Draymond Green. Draymond Green with 9 assists to Steph Curry last time out against the Cleveland Cavaliers on Monday night, and it started ugly here. But he's kept with it, like you said, Durrell, and he got to the cup early. You mentioned this at halftime. He got an easy basket before the half and got to the cup. And, yes, the struggles were still there, but he had great, great looks, and he finally got going there in overtime.
Yeah, he finally got it going. I think some of those shots in the beginning in that first half were some tough ones. He did have some open shots. I know he wants back, you know, those two shots in the corner. He was wide open, and he missed. But, you know, will to win, you know, being a great player, find a way.
And I still think he misses Green out there because they got into such a good rhythm together. that was part of his scoring. So for him to actually, as the game went on, get better and hit the game winner is impressive.
And we see Ayesha Curry.
Hey.
Hey.
No.
Dagger,
baby, is over.
That's what you saw in overtime there again. That the last three buckets there for the Warriors, a Curry three, Wiggins three in the corner, set up on a Curry pass there to a wide open Wiggins. And then the dagger, as Ayesha says. But look, she got a lot of Steph Curry got a lot of help from his boy, his Under Armour partner, Kent Bazemore. Or as the fans say here out here in the Bay Area, Baze God. Look, as you mentioned, Darrell, he had energy in the first half with 10 points, kept them afloat, kept them stabilized. And then in overtime in the fourth quarter, he just started getting buckets, going to the rack. 26 points tonight, 8 rebounds, 3 steals, and 3 assists. Bazemore was everywhere.
He was everywhere. He was the game changer tonight. He was aggressive. He got in the paint. He found guys around the perimeter, and he rebounded. Those 8 rebounds was big time because he got on the offensive glass as well.
Huge. Huge game, obviously, for him. And I liked what he said about him and Steph working out together and him taking on that mindset of positivity, because he has struggled a little bit this season. And he's a much better player, I think, than what he was doing earlier. This is who he is.
Yeah.
And I think if he can play like this the remainder of the season, there are a lot more wins on the way.
And, Jennifer, you can't dismiss the energy that he brings every single night.
Yep.
Even though he struggles, he still will bring energy. And he'll go, look, he'll commit some fouls. He'll start chirping at players. But he does bring that energy, and that energy was contagious tonight.
Absolutely. And once one player has that and then another one gets it, one hits a shot, another, it's contagious. And everybody started to play with that type of mindset and energy, especially in the overtime.
Darrell, they've had some great wins this season, beating the Lakers down at Staples Center, coming back against the L.A. Clippers. We know about the Blazers game when Curry dropped the 60-burger. Is this right here the best win of the season when you consider all the injuries they had?
I got to get us the number one spot. Yep. Just the will to win. You know, I said that already, but having Draymond, your defensive anchor, your leader on defense, and your facilitator, you know, averaging, 14 assists the last 5 games, just doing a great all-around job. This was a big-time win for them, and I hope they just build on this one and try to rack up more wins.
And here's Draymond Green waiting for his teammates here. After that big-time win, Draymond, of course, out. He got the scratch right before tip-off here with right ankle soreness, greeting Kent Bazemore and Steph Curry back there. Look at Raymond Ritter. Hey, Raymond, what's up? What's up, Raymond? Shout out Raymond Ritter, their PR director. But they need Draymond. They need Wiseman. We heard the news earlier today that Wiseman may be back on Friday. Looney's around the corner here. They go small tonight. It gets a tough and the Heat are grimy, and they're big and they're physical. Bam by the bio. They got to see it one more time. Not for a while, though, but the Heat are a good team. Mm-hmm. I know their record doesn't reflect it, but to steal that game down 19 points is just huge for these guys, like Kelly Oubre Jr., Wiggins, and of course, Kent Bazemore.
Yeah, that was a big-time win for the confidence as well. This is a team that went to the NBA Finals last year. They play really well together. I know they've been going through a lot of injuries this season, but, hey, they found a way to win. In Miami, they always make the game ugly.
Right.
That's what they're known for, making the game ugly. And at the end of the game, we'll live with the results.
No doubt. And we're going to talk Kelly Oubre Jr. here because nobody's talking about him. He's been, he's been criticized a lot here in the Bay Area for his game. But you know what? Quietly, he came to play. He rebounds. He's been rebounding a lot better for this team. And the 23 points, 9-15. I know he missed the last shot there before regulation. But 4 threes tonight. And he kept the Warriors in the basketball game. A quietly effective game here, Jennifer.
He did. And I think he's really coming into his own here. I think he's finding his rhythm, his place, feeling the chemistry, and that's hard to do too with so many players out. I mean, imagine if Chris is back also, and Looney, and Wiseman, and the rest of the team. I mean, this is going to be a pretty, pretty tough team, I think, this season still.
For sure.
Kelly Oubre Jr. adjusting here, as Jennifer said. He's going to the cup. He's starting to make the threes, and he's not looking down at the three-point line anymore. He's got that out of his repertoire here, Darrell.
Yeah, he's just letting it fly. He's playing a great game, great few games. And the one thing I've always respected about Kelly, makes and misses don't affect him on the defensive end. He stays the course. He tries to guard the best player on each and every team every night. And tonight we've seen him hit some big-time threes, get to the basket, some nice little putbacks. So he's doing a great job as well.
As a coach, Jennifer, what does this mean for Steve Kerr going into that locker room, seeing the way they come back, and then they're about to go on the road for 4 games, heck, 7 of the last 8 before the All-Star break. What does it mean for a coach to see his team fight like that, scrap and claw before going out on the road?
I mean, it means everything because, you know, there's so much momentum in basketball, and I think the fact that they were able to get it towards the end of the game and being down as much as they were, it's a huge moral victory for them. So I think they should have a ton of confidence going to these next few games, because I think this season they have done a pretty good job at winning the, quote, winnable games. I wouldn't have said tonight was necessarily a winnable game. To your point, the Heat had been in the Eastern Conference Finals, champions last year. This is a good Heat team, so big win tonight.
As a player, Darrell, you go in that locker room, coming back from 19, knowing you're shorthanded. What are they doing in the locker room right now, Steph Curry and company? How are they celebrating this win?
They feel good about themselves. They know we can do this every single night. You know what I mean? Probably don't want to take this long to do it and have to go into overtime, but this is what you build on. You want to be a good team. You want to be a playoff team. These are the wins that will build that character. So this is a big-time win. They should be happy and proud tonight.
And now the Warriors are 3 games over .500 at 16-13. They go on the road to take on the Orlando Magic on Friday.